Dungeons and Dragons. The hobby once associated with smelly basement-dwelling neckbeards has now spilled over to the mainstream. Everyone from professional voice actors, comedians, and even A-list Hollywood actors and actresses are getting in on the fun of this tabletop role-playing game.
What?
Oh my god!
Harsh DM alert, harsh DM alert.
But I don't need to tell you that. Let's say that you, a fairly experienced Dungeons & Dragons player, wanted to introduce this world of infinite possibilities to your Valentine this Valentine's. I mean, what's more romantic than slaying an evil chromatic dragon alongside your loved one? So hello, my name is Renzo with Quit Stalling, and this Valentine's Day, we're handing out some tips to make it easier for you to roll persuasion and get your loved one into D&D. Remember, Dungeons & Dragons, while it may be fun for people like you and me, may not exactly be fun for your cherie. And you know what? That's totally fine. The following tips are merely suggestions to make that D&D pitch go a little smoother and easier for you and your partner. At the end of the day, nothing is more romantic than respecting each other's wishes. So, with that out of the way, let's get right into it. Tip number one. Find their flavor of adventure. Dungeons & Dragons is a tabletop role-playing game that can literally be about anything. Fire-breathing dragons protecting treasure? Classic. Sailing across a sea of stars on another plane of reality to hunt down the cosmos? Yep. Intense political drama between two kingdoms who are at the brink of war? Yep. That too. When you've got options for adventures as broad as 5th edition Dungeons & Dragons offers you, the first obstacle might be making sure it doesn't overwhelm your dearest significant other, or on the opposite end of the spectrum, come off as a little too broad or unspecific. So, as is the foundation of any relationship, communication is key. Talk to them about their favorite fantasy adventure movies, TV shows, books, even games. Are they the classic dungeon-delving, goblin-slaying, treasure-hunting type? Or do they want to infiltrate a demonic cult to stop an evil ritual from happening? Maybe they want to accompany a band of gnomes traveling across the land on their journey to musical stardom. Remember, there are no wrong ways to have fun in Dungeons & Dragons. At the end of the day, the player's enjoyment is paramount.
Yeah!
Here's another tip. Try inviting their friends to come along and play D&D for the first time too. Nothing beats rolling dice and role-playing make-believe adventures with your best friends. Helps get all those first-time role-playing jitters out of the way too. So don't be afraid to first get to know the kind of make-believe adventure your significant other would want to go on, and take it from there. Tip number two, help create their character so they've said yes to giving Dungeons & Dragons a shot. Congratulations! Now the easy part is over. Now comes probably the most tedious portion of introducing D&D to anyone, character creation. Now don't let me speak for every single player out there. Character creation can be fun, but there's a reason why dungeon masters have to sometimes sit their players down for an entire day just to create their character sheets. It can all be so daunting. But this is where you come in. Don't let them anywhere near the tedious intricacies of first-time character creation unless you want to possibly bore them or overload them with information before the game even starts. You should have at least some decent stock knowledge on the races and classes available in 5th edition Dungeons & Dragons so you can be the bridge to the admittedly intimidating player's handbook. And as I said earlier, this is where our good old friend communication comes in again. Talk to them about the character that they'd want to play. In a pure beginner's case, you might want to start them off with something as simple as a barbarian, rogue, fighter, monk, or ranger. My personal recommendation is to keep them away from spellcasters because the concept of spell slots, materials, verbal, somatic, what, can be a little intimidating for first-time players. But again, my rules don't have to be yours. Do whatever you think is right for them. And remember, as is the case with many D&D rules, they can be easily bent or even broken to make things easier or more fun for first-time players, aka the apple of your eye. If they really want to play a spellcaster but find spell slots confusing, then do without them for the first introductory game. As long as everyone's having fun and you're somewhat still sticking to the system, it should be no problem. And for our third and final tip, buy them dice. The pillar of every Dungeons & Dragons multiverse. This dice is God, the devil, and everything in between. Judge, jury, and executioner. This polyhedral, aka 20-sided dice and all of its companions, will dictate the flow of your game's story and the fate of your characters and everything that they want to say or do. It's why anyone who regularly plays Dungeons & Dragons has a special connection with their first set of dice. Or, in many cases, several sets of dice. Dice can turn the most skeptic folks into superstitious fanatics, with pre-rolling rituals, favored dice, and even going as far as locking poorly rolling dice away in something called dice jail. Yep, we're looking at you, Laura Bailey.
Cocked. What'd you roll? Is it a natural one?
Yes, it was.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yes, it was, Matthew.
Oh, I'm sorry.
The relationship a D&D player has with their first set of dice is a monumental one. So why not make it even more special by getting one in your significant other's favorite color or design? The same reason you should be creating their character sheet for them. Nothing is more romantic than making this whole process easier for your first-time adventurer and longtime lover. Unless it's respecting their decisions if they ultimately decide that D&D is not for them. Because again, folks, that's totally okay. There you have it. Set up a fun little introductory one-shot tailored to what you learned about their preferred flavor of adventure in tip number one. Have them play the character that you made for them in tip number two. And surprise them with their first set of fate-deciding dice that you got in tip number three. So this Valentine's season, we wish you the best of luck in your shared adventures in both the multiverse of Dungeons & Dragons and boring old real life. Again, my name is Renzo. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at RenzoSaurus. Get off your butts! There's dungeons to explore, dragons to slay, and quit stalling. Happy Valentine's Day.